In part two of our sugar tax series, we talked to Bruce Barrett, general manager at John Barrett & Unlimited, a family-owned Bermuda-based beverage distributor since the year 1874. The company distributes a range of sparkling and still beverages in canned and plastic bottles and also offers a wide variety of imported waters, juices, teas, coffees, energy drinks, and of course, sodas. We asked Mr. Barrett his take on the sugar tax and how it is impacting business, particularly the soda business.
It will have, yes, had an impact, and it varies by product, by package, and even by category, because under the heading of sugary beverages are juice drinks as well as sodas, which have added sugar and are carbonated. Bermudians have been moving away from drinking sugar-sweetened sodas for decades. So it's very difficult for me to say definitively that the boost in duty from 35% up to 75% has been, you know, the final nail in the coffin of sugary beverages. On one side, if you've raised the duty on packaged sodas ready to go, people are, yeah, well, I want something sweet to get me through the afternoon. I want to treat myself. They'll find something else. It really comes, honestly, Dianne, it's education. If the consumers are educated of what you should be eating, drinking, and what exercise you should be doing to maintain a healthy weight and have a healthy lifestyle, then yeah. I mean, if you eat nothing but processed foods and sit on the couch all day and night and don't do any kind of physical activity, you are going to develop some kind of chronic disease. I'm sorry.
Do you think the sugar tax is working?
Well, I'd rather that the health ministry and customs and the finance ministry answer that. Right. From our side as a beverage distributor, it was imposed. We have to live with it. We pay our duty as we always do, and the government gets the revenue. We get the items off the dock. We pass on the expense, and we're out there merchandising coolers and shelves 7 days a week because hopefully consumers will still want the products that we sell. We've got 69 staff, and really the only way Barrett's makes money is selling products. So As long as people are buying our products, we'll keep people employed. Is it working? We just have to adapt to it. We can't change it, that's for sure.